Good morning, student. Today I am going to revise you some question from the sample paper of term 1. So I have taken this time chapter number 2, and we all know this time MCQ questions are coming. We have already discussed chapters in my previous video many times, 3-4 times I've discussed this chapter, and we have also discussed how to fill OMR sheet. Now children, today I am thinking to revise from both the part from this lesson. Okay, now how type of question you will be getting in the examination, that is very necessary. And few tips I wanted to give you, that how to fill your OMR sheet. Now children, OMR sheet, you have to fill up the circle. We have already guided you how to fill up the circle. But the main thing is that you have to write ABCD in capital letter. This is the rule which every student have to follow. You have to write the options ABCD with a capital letter. And children, it is the evaluators who will be seeing that you have filled the box or not. That is square box. Okay. Circular box is circular. Circle is for unattempted question. But the question which you are attempting, children, that should be pointed in the black box. And the most important thing, you have to fill up the box with capital ABCD. Now, children, many children I have seen what students have been doing, like in class that when we were doing the evolution, I have seen many students, they were circling. They were doing the circling of ABCD, but they were not filling the boxes. So in that case, you will be getting zero. So please, you have to see all this thing while doing your examination. And from next week, your term 1 examination is going to start. And all the best for your examination. Now I will be explaining you what type of questions may come to you in your examination. Like in MCQ also, this time we are having MCQ questions, options, sub options, and then again sub option. So you have to be very careful. You have to go through it. You have done it very well in your term 1 half yearly examination. Okay, but now the main examination is over your head, so you have to be very careful. Now I'm going to revise. I'm going to discuss some of the question. Now question number 1. I'm going to read what type of question will be coming. So listen the question carefully. Now this is from the sample paper, and from today we are going to do the sample paper. So read the following extract and answer the question that follow. Now an extract is given to you from this chapter, and then the options are there. Okay, now I'm going to read the paragraph. So actually this is a type of extract based question, we can say. So but Evelyn was not going to give up. She was determined to lead a normal life. Once again, I will read everything twice, okay? And you have to hear carefully. But Evelyn was not going to give up. She was determined to lead a normal life and pursue her interest in music. One day, she noticed a girl playing a xylophone and decided that she wanted to play it. One day, she noticed a girl playing a xylophone and decided that she wanted to play it too. Most of the teacher discouraged her, but percussionist Ron Forbes spotted her potential. He began by tuning two large drums to different notes. So this is the paragraph. Once again, I would like to read your paragraph. But Evelyn was not going to give up. She was not determined to lead a normal life and pursue her interest in music. One day she noticed a girl playing a xylophone and decided that she wanted to play it too. Most of the teacher discouraged her, but percussionist Ron Forbes spotted her potential. He began by tuning two large drums to different notes. Now the MCQ question, your question are, what was Evelyn going to give up? Okay, what was No, children, the four option along with the question I'm going to read. The question number one is, what was Evelyn not going to give up? And the four option is A, leading to a normal life, B, interest in music, C, her dream of going Royal Academy of Music, and D is both A and B. So A is leading a normal life and B is interest in music. Okay, so now what you have to do, you have to read the four option and then you have to circle as well as you have to write the correct option in the box and the capital with the capital letter. So the correct option is both A and B, that is D1. The correct option is D. Now what you have to do, in your sample paper, this type of boxes will be there, circle will be there. Okay, so you have to fill up the circle like this. All right, and then there will be two boxes here and here are oval boxes. So if you are not attempting the question, then you fill this box. If you have attempted like here, D, you have to fill it properly with the royal blue ball pen, and here you have to write capital D. So in this manner you have to fill up the boxes. Now don't write in a small letter, okay? And don't children forget, if you are circling it properly, but if you are not writing anything in this box, then you will be given zero. So you have to pay attention to all this. Now question number two. Now this type, a new type of question is coming. CBSC has introduced a new type of question. Now choose the answer that lists the correct option about the instrument that Evelyn wanted to play. Now children, this is a very nice question. I will try to show you four type of instruments are given here. Okay, four type of instruments are given here, right? Now you can see, I will try to show you you can see this is the four type of instruments are there. You can see this is in the question paper. Okay, I think you can see. All right, have you seen? Okay, so choose the answer that lists the correct option about the instrument that Evelyn wanted to play. Now what is the question here? So children, here the correct answer is A. Okay, she was a percussionist and she loved to play xylophone also. Now question number three. In the given extract, Ron Forbes come out. Ron Forbes was a person who motivated Evelyn Glennie, otherwise everybody refused that they will not teach her music. But it was Ron Forbes who motivated her, who was a person who became a godfather in her life. Whatever Evelyn Glennie was, it was just due to Ron Forbes. So children, in the given extract, Ron Forbes comes out as a motivation, then mentor, role model, all of this. Okay, so once again I read, he came as a motivation, this is also correct. Then mentor means guru, teacher, this is also correct. Role model, this is also correct. As per option D, all of these. So option D again is correct. You have to circle it, you have to write D like this. Okay, now question number four. Why did Ron Forbes tune two large drum? Okay, now in this question we are having option and sub option. Okay, in question number four you have to read it very carefully. It is option and sub option. So read, I'm reading it and you have to listen it very carefully. Once again I read. Why did Ron Forbes tune two large drum? So there are three major option is there, and then the sub option is there. Okay. So to teach Evelyn, first option is to teach Evelyn to listen from her mind and other body parts. Second, to teach Evelyn how to play drum. Third, to show Evelyn that he could play drum. To show Evelyn that he could play drum. Only it is correct. Only it is correct. A. Now these are the sub option I am going to read. Now B, both 1 and 3 are correct. What is the 1? To teach Evelyn to listen from her mind and other body. And third is to show Evelyn that he could play drum. So both 1 and 3 are correct. Then C is only 1 is correct. C is only 1 is correct. D is none of these. So children, it is 1 is correct. Okay. So only to teach Evelyn to listen from her mind and other body part. So this is the correct answer. So here you have to circle A, here you have to write capital A. Okay, like this. Now suppose if you are not attempting this question, so what you will write? You will write nothing here and you will feel this. If you are not attempting this question, because this time choice is there, a lot of choice is there in all the question. Okay, and you have not attempted this question, so you have to fill this circle which is of non-attempted. I hope I am clear to you. Okay. Now read the following extract and answer the question that follow. Now one another extract I am reading. Okay. Now, and for all this Evelyn won't accept any hint of heroic achievement. And for all this Evelyn won't accept any hint of heroic achievement. If you work hard and know where you are going, you will get there. If you work hard and know where you are going, you will get there. And she got right to the top, the world most sought after multi-percussionist with a mastery of some thousand instruments and hectic international schedule. Now, the first is all this in the given extract referred to her career as a percussionist, her journey in the Royal Academy of Music. She is receiving the highest marks in the history of Royal Academy of Music, and D is both B and C. So once again I read all the children, I'm going to read all the options one again. Her career as a percussionist, her journey in the Royal Academy of Music, receiving the highest marks in the history of Royal Academy of Music, and then both B and C. Okay. Now, so now you have to choose the correct answer, and it is the D1. It is the D1. Now second I'm going to read. Okay, choose the option that lists the act of statement that are not true according to the given statement. Now this is again a new type of question is there. Choose the option that lists the set of statement that are not true according to the given state. Evelyn was very determined. Evelyn became a very eminent percussionist. Evelyn did not participate in international concerts. Evelyn knew how to play only the xylophone. Evelyn became a teacher at the Royal Academy of Music. Now this is a five option are there, and then the sub option is also there. So once again I read the five option and then the sub options I'm going to read. So what are the five options? Evelyn was very determined. Evelyn became a very eminent percussionist. Evelyn did not participate in international concerts. Evelyn knew how to play only the xylophone. Evelyn became a teacher at the Royal Academy of Music. Now A is 1, 2, 3. B is 3, 4, 5. And C is 1, 3, 5. And D is 2, 4. 2, 4. Once again, A is 1, 2, 3, B is 3, 4, 5, C is 1, 3, 5, and D is 2, 4. This type of questions are coming, a lot of questions I have seen in the sample paper. So here you have to read all the options very carefully. Like here 1, 2, 3, so you have to write, you have to see what is 1, Evelyn was very determined, second is Evelyn became a very eminent percussionist. 3 is Evelyn did not participate in international concert. Now what you feel, this third one is not correct. Okay, so 1 is not there. 1 we can is not the correct answer. Now let's go to the B one. So it is 3, Evelyn did not participate in international concert. 4, Evelyn knew how to play only the xylophone. 5, Evelyn became a teacher at the Royal Academy of Music. So she did not become a teacher. Now children, the question is choose the option that lists the set of statements that are not true. That set you have to choose in which all the options are not true. So in first one there are 2 options are correct and the third one is not correct. But in this option B1 all the options are not correct. And this is what you have the question demand. You have to write choose those MCQ, number of MCQ, in which all the answers are not true. So it is the B1. It is the B1. Now, third, pick the option that correctly classify facts F and options S. This is again a very new type of question. Pick the option that correctly classify facts, and F is written for facts and option is written for O. Okay. So pick the option that correctly classify facts, F and option O of the students below. Now, first, I think Evelyn worked really hard to reach her place. I will be reading twice each and everything. I think Evelyn worked really hard to reach her place. I think Evelyn should have focused on only one instrument. I think Evelyn inspired a lot of people. I think Evelyn loved music to her core. Once again, I read. I think Evelyn worked really hard to reach a place. I think Evelyn should have focused on only one instrument. I think Evelyn inspired a lot of people. I think Evelyn loved music to her core. Okay. So A is, fact is 1, 3 and option is 2, 4. B is fact is 1, 3, 4 and option is 2. C is fact is 2, 3 and option is 1, 4. And D is fact is 3, 4 and option is 1, 2. Okay, so children, here you have to do very careful reading. Okay, very very careful reading. So we can say here B1 is the correct answer. Fact is 1, 3, 4 and option is 2. Fact is 1, 3, 4 and option is 2. Now the phrase most sought after indicate. Now children, here the meaning of word meaning and phrases are also asked. Okay, so the one phrase is given here, most sought after, indicates popularity. A, B is stardom, C is fan following, fan, F-A-N, fans following. Both D is both A and C. So it is, children, what is the option? What do you think is the correct option here? So the correct option here again is D. Now the word hectic, all right, the word hectic. Now here the word meaning is also so you have to go through the word meaning also. Crazy, leisurely, vibrant, and D is flush. Carely, hesitantly, vibrant, and this is flush, F-L-U-S-H. So the correct answer is vibrant. Hectic means here vibrant. Okay, so children, this type of question is coming, the paragraph is given to you. Okay, now one more type of question is there, which is only simple MCQ type. Okay, now what did Evelyn now first is Evelyn realized about the approaching train by feeling two, they say filling the blanks. Okay, see the question is, Evelyn realized about the approaching train by feeling its sound, vibration, structure and crowd. So definitely she felt it by vibration. Now question number 2, why was the first day at the prestigious Royal Academy of Music in London was daunting for Evelyn? Okay, so here let me read the question once again. Why was the first day at the prestigious Royal Academy of Music in London was daunting for Evelyn? So because she was an unexperienced Scottish musician, because she was deaf, because she was in London for the first time, then D is A and B. So definitely it will be the D one. Okay, now again children, you can see the pictures. The question is that what did Evelyn used to play when she was 8 years old? What did Evelyn used to play when she was 8 years old? Okay, now here you can see the pictures. These pictures I will be showing you, and I feel this is the A1 is the correct answer. This is the correct answer. Okay, A. So this type of pictures are also coming in the examination. Okay, you have to see the picture very very carefully and then write the answers. Now who said the following dialogue? Now children, dialogue also is coming. Okay, diagram is coming, dialogue is coming, extract based question is coming. So this is a very interesting question, okay. So the dialogue is, who said the following dialogue? They called her name and she did not move. I suddenly realized she hadn't heard. Once again, what is the dialogue? They called her name and she did not move. I suddenly realized she hadn't heard. So first is Evelyn Glennie, Isabel Glennie, interviewer, James Blades. So it is the B1 is the correct answer, Isabel Glennie. Isabel Glennie. Now, question number 5. When did Evelyn feel everything so dark in her life? When did Evelyn feel everything so dark in her life? B. When she was advised to go to a deaf school, when she was advised to use hearing aids and go to the deaf school, when she performed poorly at the examination, when she failed in her music audition, when she was advised to go to a deaf school, when she was advised to use hearing aids and go to the deaf school, when she was performed poorly at the examination, when she failed in her music audition. Okay, so children, what I feel the correct answer is, when she was advised to use hearing aids and go to the deaf school. Okay, so all this type of question, children. So today we have done the first part. Often I will be telling you what type of question will be coming. Thank you for watching my video, and whatever instruction I've given to you, please follow it. Thank you and have a nice day ahead. Bye bye.